So far, we've created a course dashboard, which has included mostly static information regarding the course. Being able to interact with students and collaborate is just as important. So for collaboration and interacting with your students, we suggest using our primary collaboration tool, 3DEXPERIENCE. 3DEXPERIENCE is set up like a web feed in which users are a part of communities that they have been invited to. And they can post all different types of content depending on their level of access. All of the communities a user is a part of are shown to the left of the page, and these communities can easily be dragged into the favorites. Clicking What's New just shows one common feed of all of the communities a user is a part of. Before we create a community of our own, let's just first take note of a couple of the key functions that might be useful in the classroom, specifically a few of the post types we have available, including questions, ideas, surveys, and wikis. Now, depending on the community settings, anyone can post a question, and it can be answered by anyone in the community. The answers can even be validated by either the person who asked the question or one of the community owners. Posting an idea is also very useful in the ideation process, as we can define different phases of our process and manage the ideas posted. When we filter on ideas, we're able to take a deeper dive into where all of the ideas exist in the process. And we can even jump into an amazing graphical representation of the entire ideas pipeline. Surveys are another great tool that instructors might want to take advantage of, and they're easy and intuitive to use and quickly gather information from the class. Wikiposts are also useful because you basically have one communal notebook of information with as many different pages as you'd like, and you can customize the hierarchy structure of all of those pages to make it more intuitive. This is a great place to add information that you would want the whole class to have access to in an organized way. Now that we know some of what we can do with a community, let's actually create one. Creating a 3DEXPERIENCE community is easy as an admin. Just go to your platform management dashboard and go to the communities tab. You can click add community. Let's say for instance, we want a community with the sole purpose of giving class announcements. We can call this community just that. Once we're in the settings, we first want to set the visibility of this community. Now, a public community is visible to anyone on our 3DEXPERIENCE platform, including people outside of this course. Private and secret communities are only viewable by invited participants. We'll make this community private for now. When we go to invite our class, we will need to grant them one of three types of access, those being contributor, author, and owner. Contributors can only make certain post types designated in the community settings. Authors can make any type of post available in that particular community, and they can also edit and delete their own posts. Only owners can edit or delete any post in the community, as well as adjust those community settings. We recommend having instructors as the owners and students as either contributors or authors, depending on the community. Because this particular community is for class announcements, maybe we wouldn't want the class to be able to post anything of their own, but just be able to comment on the class announcements we make. In that case, we could invite the class as contributors and just turn off all the features for contributors with the checkboxes shown here. Maybe we decide it would be useful for them to contribute questions and ideas to this community though. So we can simply check those boxes and now contributors can post questions or ideas. We can also customize the idea settings here as well by adding or removing statuses and altering their names, colors, and order. Once we're satisfied, we can just click apply and then add the users we want to. Like we decided before, we'll invite our entire class to this community and we can take advantage of our handy user group that we created in a previous video and grant the entire class the contributor level of access. And now let's jump into our community and start using it. For the sake of a course, we recommend including at least one community for the whole class. However, we may want group members to be able to have more freedom in smaller group communities. So we can make sure the group members are either authors or owners of those communities as well. And we can just adjust the other settings as needed. To recap, we just went through the basics of 3DEXPERIENCE communities, how to create one, how to manage its settings, and invite users. In the next video, Gian will show you how to use the 3D search function and 6W tags to find different content and information in the communities or just on the 3D Experience platform in general.